Society, and today it is Thursday, and the topic which I am going to tell you is that it is analytical articles or analytical paragraphs based on visual stimulus. What is visual stimulus? I would like to tell you that this year onwards, the syllabus of CBSE 10th class English, there is a slight change in question number 4. In fact, in place of question number 4, which used to be of story writing, now it will be an analytical writing, including a paragraph or article, which will be based on stimulus. Stimulus will be visual, and the current screen you can see, it has certain boxes. In these, some posters, some topics are written, which will be given this year onwards in the board examination. The first one I would like to tell you that it is about a poster which tells about fire accidents, and this is one of the information given by Delhi Fire Service, which tells that in a particular area that thousands of lives are taken by the fire accidents, where the public can stop these accidents, and even they can prevent these accidents by informing the police, or you can say by informing the fire service, Delhi Fire Service in fact. So it is an informative advertisement, you can say, or it can be a poster which is informing a common public that everybody should be aware of the facts that we can prevent fires. So you are given this particular box or the poster on the basis of which you have to write a paragraph of 100 and 150 words. It can be of marks 8 to 10. So I come to next one. Where this is a verbal input given about river water pollution, and where we have to write a paragraph in 125 words approximately on this topic of water pollution, its reasons and preventions. So this is given. When you enlarge your screen, you can easily see this document. And next one I come to, the next question is again the topic of this picture is how to keep your city clean, and you see this picture and you have to write an article based on this picture. This picture shows that some cattle feeding on the garbage thrown by the people around in the neighborhood. On this particular topic you have to write your topic in about 125 words or 100 to 150 words, and so on. We have many more stimulus and visual stimulus which are provided in the question paper in the sample. So this way some graphical inputs are also there, some tabular form is also there, and some graphical representation or the map of India is also given, where you have to write certain articles based on, I tell you the topic of this particular one, that map given below shows the weather condition in the major cities of India. We have to study the map where minimum and maximum temperature weather forecast is given of the cities and the places, and on the basis of this we have to write a paragraph in about 150 words based on this comparative study of the weather conditions in these cities. Now children, I have a screen for the marking scheme for the following particular writing section, the question number 4, which is article or paragraph writing, where 1 mark is allotted for द फॉर्मेट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर राइटिंग सेक्शन, दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, एंड 1 mark ऑल्सो विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू यू फॉर हेडिंग एंड राइटिंग द राइटर्स नेम ऑल्सो. सो द टॉप मोस्ट पार्ट ऑफ हेडिंग विल बी ऑफ 1 mark एंड ओवरऑल मार्क फॉर फॉर्मेट इज 1 mark सेपरेटली. सो फॉर कंटेंट, द मेन कंटेंट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर आर्टिकल राइटिंग इज 4 marks एज इट कम्स आउट टू बी अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 5, 4, 9, 1, 10. सो दिस राइटिंग सेक्शन विल कॉन्स्टिट्यूट 10 marks इन ऑल. सो 1 mark अलॉटेड फॉर हेडिंग, 1 mark फॉर 4 marks फॉर कॉन्टेंट, एंड 2.5 and 2.5 दैट इज डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट्स ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन. द फर्स्ट 2.5 marks आर अलॉटेड टू द ग्रामेटिकल एक्यूरेसी विच इज कॉल्ड ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक्स एंड ऑल एवरीथिंग विल बी कंसिडर्ड एंड सर्टेन रेलिवेंट वर्ड्स विच आर स्पेसिफिकली रिटन बाई द स्टूडेंट्स बेस्ड ऑन द वोकैबुलरी विच आर higher level words, you can say that better vocabulary words which are used, and the spelling mistakes will be considered here in this case, where 2.5 marks out of 5 will be considered for this particular section. Now I just come to the consistency and significance of ideas and style. This means that your topic should be relevant and it has a link between all particular segments of this paragraph, segments of this particular parts of the paragraph for writing. For example, introduction, main content, and the conclusion. All these three should be interlinked. They should not have some irrelevant data which can lead to deduction of some marks. So that contains 2.5 marks. And your ideas, your style, your own input, personal own development, you can say framing, and giving your own personal views and ideas makes it innovative writing. When student gives an innovation or your own writing style, that gives that puts a better impression on the examiner, and you are rewarded for better marks. So this way, this is the marking scheme of this paragraph writing. I come to the main point, format of an article. Format of article is divided into 3 main parts. Part 1 is heading, second part is byline, and third one is body. You can see heading in blue, that the heading of the article should be engaging, and it should not exceed more than 5 to 6 words, maybe sentence. Make sure that heading should not be sentence, that heading doesn't have any spelling mistake or grammatical errors, and do not use unnecessary punctuation marks in the heading. So heading carries 1 mark in article writing. Second one is byline. Byline is here, I just highlight byline, and this byline is nothing but, I just shorten it. Byline is nothing but the name of the person who is writing the article. The name of the person will be generally given in the question paper itself, and if the name of person is not given in the article, then write details on your own. But it should not be written specifically your own real name. It should be some other name should be written. Now I come to body. Body is the main part of the article writing which carries more weightage or marks. Generally, the body of the article consists of at least 3 to 4 paragraphs. It can be less also, it can be 2 also, but generally a common writing contains 3 to 4 paragraphs. First paragraph can be the introduction paragraph. Second paragraph can be, it is the main topic which contains the main content of the paragraph. including third also, which contains the main content with conclusion of the topic. That way it can be done. Now I come to the types of paragraph. Here the writer must analyze and explain what are the different types of problems that are existing. In any type of problem exists, they should mention in this particular part. Now types of the paragraph may come. It can be current affairs, current scenario, like Indo-China relations. It can be COVID-19. It can be anything. It can be current scenario of World War situation, or Indo-Pak relations, political, scientific developments, or any topic you can see in the newspapers which may come. And the cause and the effect relationships, you have to write what are the causes and effects of the relationships. Develop the cause and effect relationship by supporting it with facts or data. It means we have to bind the writing with the help of facts or data. You should have correct data and correct facts, which I'm just I'll just highlight it for you. See, brush. In this case, you can see this particular facts or data. This should be available to you. Otherwise, your writing will not be so much effective. So now I just come to this one. Now, we have certain tips which you can read always, so that I just want to make this. So I come to an end because I just do not want to make it longer. So these are certain article writing format tips given by CBSE. There are 8 tips, you can always read it. I'll just support this particular document in the PDF format, so that you will be able to see in your phones, in your laptops or some media. So we have other sample topics also, on which you have to write one topic, any one of these 4 you have to write in your FAIR notebook. So dear students, complete the homework. I wish that you are putting your attendance regularly as well as completing your homework daily. So I just want to tell you that this document will be forwarded on your WhatsApp group. So thank you so much and have a nice day.